Zest is in the air. Okay, I'm doing a thing. What thing am I doing? Okay, I've had that bad digi bag and yet I'll deal with it later for now. That's what you want. Unskippable. From near or far. I think I may or no, I have not, because that's a place I can go. Avagon, and this is where this is the Renegade Special Mission. No, Renegade Special Mission takes place on go on Mavigon. Have I already been on Mavigon? I don't think so, because that does not look surveyed. The bottom line. A trio's down to two. It's magic everywhere. With all this romantic atmosphere. Disaster's in the air. Always been It's right, it's right. Singing badges. Obviously cool. There's a kitten looking at the door. He's got big dreams. Don't know what he's fighting for. I don't think I've ever deaded myself in Nazareth. It's been too long since I promise her. Mass Effect came out in 2007, 12 years ago. Snuggles for the kitten. Where do we go from here? Just those things that I can see. So let's go south. South. Yeah. light pink sun. A rhyme of this. Exactly where I'm going, and I'm okay with that. I'm marginally okay with that. Coming around with Bumblebee, baby. Daddy has D. He's not getting nice D. Heavens, what's up? You see? You got the dog's attention. That's what happens. Okay, now I have to redo everything I accomplished here. Which is unfortunate. No. You will not get my iced tea. I can see you looking at it avidly. I can see you jumping up. I can see you going after it right now. This is probably one of Helena Blake's markers.
There we go.
Maybe wait for the kid to come to you. Suggestion? they had simulated different gravity levels. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally get away, so long as we're tired, all the way from the war. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Seriously, kid? Yeah. Iced tea. Over that mountain and over the next mountain. To the unmarked place we go. Make oak bounds. Our spirits will drown. Some think some snow. Coming in from another angle, huh? You are determined to get my tea. And to walk on my lap at every opportunity. Surprisingly, I am a little bit distracted. Thank you. I'd on the other side of that. So that's where. This time, I'm gonna be smart about what I'm doing, see? I'm gonna save when I get to the thing with the rockets, so that in case I get attacked by a random kitten once again. Or if I do. Profit. That's easy. Yep. Okay, I gotta get back in the game. Right. About to die. Okay. That's an example of... too big for your britches. There you go. I knew you wanted to attack me. Okay. Why am I here? Yep. I'm here to kill drug dealer slash saber room slaver. Go. Enemies everywhere. Joke's on you, kitten. I already drank all my tea.
Locked and loaded. Rex.
One more to go, and then I talk to Helena. Helena.
Perimeter secured.
Some people call me the Space Batman. Tool. Massive cooldown bonus. All right, you're gonna attack my foot. Let's go ahead and make it easy for you. Shepard, buy out a camp. Those Solaris amps are garba. Oh wow, that's a really great. Better duration bonus, worse cooldown bonus, and that's just worse all around. I think I'll keep him with the Prodigy. Tool and combat exoskeleton. Tally, let's give you a combat exoskeleton. And let's look at that Omni Tool. Yeah, no, we're gonna stick with the Omni Tool. Dogs were all transported far beyond the northern sea. Puppy, puppy, I've been thinking what a grand world it would be if the cats were all transported far beyond the northern sea. One crime boss dead. One more to go. Thank you. Generally speaking, yes. Specifically, no. Six. Sounds like incomplete. Maintaining the metabolism rate. This is where the party ends. I can't stand here listening to you, your racist friend. I know politics more, but I feel like I'm talking to you, your racist friend.
secured.
For the moment. Corporate accounts payable, Nana speaking. Just a moment. Corporate accounts payable, Nana speaking. What they'll find is just a statue standing where the statue got me high. I hear a kitten, feel mostly. And here, I guess. A kitten under my chair. See, that's an additional almost 200 damage. That's way more damage. Combat optics. Do ya? Hot diggity daffodils.
This they received a supply ship just 2 days ago. The Rachni must have attacked since then.
Tell me about that supply ship. This planet is supposed to be uninhabited. The Rachni didn't come from nowhere.
One moment. These things are drones, dispatched at irregular intervals from different depots to reduce the likelihood of tracking. I have it. This one came from Argos Row.
Argos Row. Visit to Argos Row, and when I do, I'm gonna do something. You'll see. You'll all see. Ain't that right, Sasha? Yeah, that's right, kid.
Wherever it is, there's probably more Rachni there. Let's get to the bottom of this.
Right.
Mayday! 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 This is Lieutenant Marie Durand, 314th Infantry, Alliance 10th Frontier Division.
That's Pi.
The listening post has been overrun by unidentified hostile life forms. Request immediate extraction.
I'm gonna have to fight more Rachni. We'll see. We'll all see. I don't think I will. I mean, not here. Elsewhere, I will, yeah. Up a level? When did that happen? I need to pay more attention to these things. Alright, is there anything else to do on this planet? I think there is. Oh my, yes, there is. Two things. Yeah. Yeah, for not paying attention.
Securing point.
Closer. Would they see a portal? No, sir. They'd find out there's so much more to me. Oh, it's good sweet tea.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you...
You bet, Commander. Boop, 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 boop.
racist,
yes,
Presley.
Commander.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Is that what you missed? It was another system. Now your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more. Oh, this is the bad guy planet. The one for the renegade thing. No, it's not. It's Noniwal. To the different planet. Okay, where am I? Where are things? What's that thing? Flare out there. We're gonna kill some bugs, cause we're guys. We're not just random bugs. We got awesome guns, a decent tank. Shepherd squad. Doing things fast. There's no face too big, no face too small. If you need help, just call John Kirk. Johnny Kirk. Got killed by Ragnai. Kind of almost spell this by accident. Sempre misero accanto ormai non sentesi e c'è appianto il tempo non ricorre ma non hai mobili. Mr. Johnson, troubles on his own, had a young man that would not leave his home.
First Lieutenant Durand, ma'am. 3rd Brigade, 14th Infantry Regiment, and I am damn glad to see you.
We heard you needed some backup.
Actually, we need to get the hell out of here. But I guess your ship couldn't carry us
Actually,
all.
It could. There's like three of you.
They dropped us here a few months back. We get supplies every couple weeks. We didn't see anything local that was more dangerous than lichen. Yesterday, these animals started coming out of the ground. No idea where they're from. This is what's left out of 90 men. I'm the ranking officer.
We do have a ship in orbit. We could bombard them.
Wouldn't do much good. They're moving around deep underground. The only time they come near the surface, and they're right on our position. You bombard them, you take us out too.
Why are you out here in the first place?
There's been a lot of pirate activity in this cluster. We set up a chain of listening posts in the local systems, in case they have a staging base.
They're called Rachni. You get a supply ship in recently?
Yeah, but that was an Alliance ship, Commander. I mean, it was a drone, running on automatics. But what...
Will the Rachni come back?
What we just fought was a probe. Our seismic sensors are picking up a crapload more on their way up from underground. We've got 5 minutes, tops. We might be able to hold them off if we were at peak, but you can see the fighting's busted this place up.
Do what you can to secure your position. We'll see if we can get some of your defenses operational.
Aye, aye, Commander. You heard the woman. Everybody pool magazines and grenades. Take a leak and a drink while you can. And if anyone wants a smoke, it's as good a time as any.
Your defenses are well operational. There was something. I'll take that. You don't need it. You're NPCs. Who cares if you die? Your mom. She was a really nice lady. Doesn't scare you, no evil thing. She's like a spider waiting for the kill. Cruella, Cruella de Vil. Covers your lips. I'm the shepherd. By the way, people are saying things. Thank you.
targets down.
Where you at, Durant? There you are.
Holy hell, ma'am. Talk about a near-run thing. You all right?
Never mind me, are you all right?
Still on my feet. But we've been fighting for almost 26 hours straight. None of us will be standing for long.
I've been fighting for 26 hours.
We're getting a signal from one of the ground scan UAVs. A big hollow space about 500 meters under the surface.
Right. That must be it. That must be where they're coming from. My people aren't in any condition for a clearing operation, though.
Just point us in the right direction.
You don't have to do that, Commander. We've bled them. We can probably... If you want to take a throw at it, we'll give you... You saved our asses, Commander. Thanks.
Let's see. Oh, my bad. Only about 17 hours, gay. Because this Shepherd, she gay. Kept on going. Fight like a Krogan, run like a rabbit, but you'll never be better than Commander Shepard. There we go. remember. Fire. Long. Wildly uncontrolled bursts. Carrying the money? The Arachnaeon Nemos. Seems very Greek to me.
Area secured.
Malacha. Oops. Bolts. Choppy load lag. There we go. I'm still choppy. Must be loading more textures. I believe I got more coming. Let's see, there's more to this planet. Not much more, we're almost done. Slow. I'll save in case the game overloads.
Got it.
Oopsie. Now I'll get back in the Mako. Do the drive and go. What the fuck is going on with it? Throwing this jug and fit. This is unpleasant, like a fart. I said it, flip you. Returning to the Normandy will clear things up. Jartar bits. It's a near run thing. But we didn't quite make it. Solve the planet. There it is. Gotta have good Grimma. Don't wanna get hit in this world. They'll forgive poor spinning, but not poor Grimma. Only gonna get one more level after that. Such a shame. Oh, almost everything is right in one spot. Young and unafraid, dreams were made and used and wasted. There was no ransom to be paid, no song unsung, wine untasted. Rex. This way, Rex. Tell me what you're doing, Rex. I'm here, Rex.
Okay. Always here.
There we go. Give me room to try and find. I guess I just can't interact with that. Weird because it looks exactly like this probe, which is not an escape button. Jesus, what have I done? Become a thief in the night, become a dog on the run. Have I fallen so far and seen out so late that nothing remains but the present hate? There isn't the body, so where I stand, journey for years. If there's a time to 20 long years, all I've never been, gave me a stealing. Should. I saw an ad for it at Hardee's. Cross promotion. Eventually watch the boys. Overjoyed. shame. Old Mr. Johnson had troubles of his own. He had a yellow cat that wouldn't leave his home. He tried and he tried to give the cat away. He gave it to a man going far, far away. But the cat came back the very next day. Stay away. Mr. Johnson's neighbor swore he'd shoot the cat on sight, and loaded up his shotgun with nails and dynamite. Waited and waited for the cat to come around. 97 pieces of the man is all they found. Gave it to a fisherman with a dollar note. Told him for to take it up the river in his boat. Tied a rope around his neck and must have weighed a pound. They had to drag the river for the fisherman was drowned. Extra special present from the what's her name? Who's we call it? What's her nuts? The consort. But here I go again on my own. Gotta kill the Rachni almost alone. Someday, mother will die and I'll get the money. Mom comes down and says my sentiments exactly. You son of a bitch, I palindrome. I palindrome. I palindrome. And I am a mistake.
Negative contacts, Commander.
See the spring of the grandfather clock unwinding. See the hands of my offspring making. Side, I palindrome, and I'm a stinkin' eating my head on the opposite side. I palindrome, man, oh man. Son, I am Ava, she said, though you scared. Said I, beloved, I said, watch me scare you, though. Said she, Abel, am I, son? Oh, I already did the spring, the grandfather clock. I screwed up the sound. Fail. Buildings tumble. Robins wide. Light beams down from heaven. She stands before my eyes. She's actual size, but she seems much bigger to me. I've never known anyone like her. She's actual size. Stuck in my heart now, where the blood belongs. She's actual size, but she seems much bigger to me. I think I'm gonna have to find my way back out of here against a horde of bugs.
Personal data recorder for Major Elena Flores.
Play the first entry.
Sigma 23 is almost fully operational. The barracks and storage lockers are complete, and we've begun stocking the munitions. It's highly unlikely the Alliance will patrol in the nebula. I expect our only risk will be from pirates, and who'll believe them? Looks like we'll have space for two reinforced platoons of Cerberus commandos.
Cerberus? I've about had it with those guys.
Play the second entry.
The package arrived today for field testing. I'm told they're fundamentally similar to the units being developed on Novaria. They promised this batch would be stable. Something about them developing in proximity to the master control unit. We detected some pirates setting up an anchorage in a neighboring system. I think we'll try deploying them there first.
Play the last entry.
They've escaped containment. Clever bastards. We treated them like animals. We should have treated them like POWs.
They're spreading. Boarding the supply ships and sending them to random destinations. They'll be all over the cluster in a week. General, if you recover this message, my advice is, screw the Rachni. They're too smart. Use one of the other projects. Flores, signing off. For the final time.
This is a familiar story. A failed experiment with the Rachni. Nice to see humans are consistently stupid.
Let's go.
Pretty sure it's just workers. Really good. Herschel. Okay, I'll go to Kepler. Herschel on the Kepler Verge. I got a kitten in my lap. And the other hand's giving a high five. Upgrade the fuck out of him. Alright, him up with mediocre weaponry. Not that mediocre. Wow. Elkos makes shitty weapons. Or Rosenkopf makes really good weapons. Looks like Rosenkopf makes really good weapons. Let's see. It'd have to be somewhere between 6 and... I don't know. Let's see, 5. It'd have to be somewhere between 10 and 15 damage. It's better to stay with the Volkov. Still better. Somewhere between 9 and 12. No, 6 and 9. More damage protection versus tech bionic protection. Or better all around. Time to kill off Celions. I think they're husks. No, they shouldn't be husks. I could have just reskinned them, called them busks or something. Pretty sure they're just husks.
Finally, some action.
Thank you. Thank you for saving me from those things.
Commander, that's him. That's Dr. Celion.
What? My name is Hart. Dr. Hart. Please, get me out of here.
Are you sure it's him?
Positive. There's no escape this time, Doctor. I'd harvest your organs first, but we don't have the time.
You're crazy. He's crazy! Please, don't let him do this to me.
We'll take him in, drop him off at the military.
But we have him. We can't let him get away. Not again.
If he dies, we'll never know what he's been up to, or how he did it.
Or who he did it
to. Interrogate him, and he'll serve his time.
Okay. You're right. You're a very lucky Salarian. You owe the commander your life.
Oh, thank you so very much.
Finally, some action.
And so he dies anyway. What was the point of that?
You can't predict how people will act, Garrus, but you can control how you'll respond. In the end, that's what really matters.
Yeah. I don't think I ever met anyone like you, Commander. Well, I guess we're done.
She's one of a kind. Two of a kind. Sort of. It is a very sweet kitten to let you do that, Wesley. And you're purring. Yeah, you guys are friends. You guys are friends. And now you gotta wash off all the dog's liver. I know, life is hard. Seriously, I feel you. Dogs are gross. Super gross. You'll get used to it. Fight like a Krogan, run like a leopard, but you'll never be better than Commander Shepard. Wesley just licked the hell out of Sasha, and Sasha put up with it. And purred. You're still purring? You happy kid. I Rigby, Sasha happy cat. No trouble at all. Cat detective man from the Ministry of Housing. Thank you. the savant.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Something bothering you?
It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
And when we do, we'll have a long, hard talk with him.
I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with... I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but... If there's anything else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and
I'll
do
it. Do you have reach and flexibility?
I understand your concern, but we will find him. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do.
Yes, ma'am. You can count on me. Thanks for hearing me out. I appreciate it. Can I ask you something, Commander?
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
I get the feeling this isn't a question.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
If Saren won't listen to reason, if he forces my hand, I'll kill him in a heartbeat. But only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him. And what about the Geth? They might try to free him.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone, but what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Maybe, maybe not. But it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, ma'am.
Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
No, I'm gonna stick with the... Definitely sticking with what I already got. Do I need to talk to everyone? Have I been missing out this whole time?
Shepard, I'm glad you're here.
Good to see you smiling again, so to speak.
Breezes?
I'm sleeping much better now. I guess I'm getting used to how quiet your ship is. But I don't want this to get in the way of our mission, Shepard. First, we stop Saren. Then I'll worry about my own problems. See you later.
Shepard.
So you'd rather be a merc than help your people?
I'm a fighter. It's what I do.
Aren't you at all worried about what will happen to the Krogan?
What the hell do you want me to do about it, Shepard? I'm tired of sticking my ass on the line and getting nothing for it.
Do you need a hug, Rex?
So you decided to go your own?
I decided. Killing for credits was better than killing for a lost cause. I'm not like you, Shepard. I'm no hero.
Well, you're half right.
Bottom line, killing for credits simplifies things.
You ever think about helping your people?
I try not to. But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. I'm always running into them. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them. But that's just part of the job. You don't get to pick who your enemies are.
How long have you been a merc?
Long enough. It's good work if it doesn't kill you.
I get the feeling you enjoy your work.
Sure. You get to see the galaxy on someone else's credits. I've tried more organized fighting, private armies and such, but it gets too messy. I fight best on my own, or in very small groups. I don't like people relying on me, and I bloody well don't like relying on them.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Commander?
Do you have a few minutes to talk?
I'm off duty until tomorrow. I was gonna have a small drink, bit of a celebration, if you're interested.
What's the occasion?
It's Armistice Day, when the first contact war ended. My family always marks it. Since I'm the only Williams aboard, I thought I'd ask you.
Seems like an odd thing to celebrate. That was 26 years ago.
In our family, it's not really a celebration, more like an obligation. Don't tell me you don't know about my family. My commanders always find out. It's not in my files or something?
There's almost nothing in your files. Technical scores and a list of crap assignments.
There's a reason for the crap assignments. I'm General Williams' granddaughter, the commander of the Shanxi garrison in the war. The only human ever to surrender to an alien race.
I see. That's why you drive yourself so hard.
A Williams has to be better than the best, if only to avoid suspicion. That's what my dad told me the night before he retired. It takes a special kind of thick-headed to march into a job where your family's blacklisted. I did it anyway. I'm not gonna let our name go down with Arnold and Quisling. Granddad deserved better than that.
What happened to your grandfather after the war?
He was relieved of command as soon as Shanxi was liberated. They brought him back to Earth in irons, but there was never a trial. They quietly demoted him and stuck him behind a desk. He retired a year later and spent the rest of his life working construction in the colonies. Sometimes we hear about attempts to get him exonerated in some official way. Nothing ever comes of them.
As I recall, your grandfather held out for a long time.
The Turians wrecked the orbitals in the first wave and occupied the major cities. They sat in orbit, dropping rocks on anything that moved. Granddad dispersed the troops, but when they went into the cities for supplies, the Turians would wreck a block to eliminate one fire team. Civilians were dying, his troops were starving, and he couldn't contact Alliance High Command. So he surrendered the garrison.
He refused to sacrifice his men just to save face for humanity. You planning to throw yourself on a sword to save face for him?
Would it make a difference? He's gone now. Dad's gone too. And who would it impress? I'll never be good enough for the Alliance. So now you know. Gonna kick me off the ship, Skipper?
You're a valuable part of my crew, Williams. If I want an opinion from the head, I go to Alenko. When I want one from the heart, I go to you.
I also play a mean game of pool. But anyway, I've got things to do before we land. I'm sure you do too.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am?
Commander, good to see you.
Time to go remind Caden that he's a boy and boys are smelly and stupid.
Anything you need, Commander?
So
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at.
I didn't figure you'd have time to talk. I mean, there are reports to file on the Rachni and on Analeas.
The paperwork will keep.
I'm just looking for an ear. The debriefing wasn't the right place to say how ridiculous
this is. You're right, this is pretty ridiculous.
It's like every other race in the galaxy is wrapped up in their own problems. They don't want to see what's coming.
Wanting to believe everything will be fine? Sounds like human nature to me.
Yeah, I guess some things carry across species well enough. I should remember that after what happened with Vernus.
I think you'd carry a grudge over the crap you took from Vernus.
Before I met Vernus, I knew as much as any other civilian. Aliens were weird, superior, and tried to tell us what to do. I mean, it's only been 26 years since first contact. That's not a lot of time to understand them. It was Vernus who made me see how human aliens are. They're not different or special. They're jerks and saints, just like us. Hell, by the time I got payback, I didn't even want it anymore.
I don't see you snapping very easily. What finally did it?
He hurt Rana. Broke her arm. She reached for a glass of water instead of pulling it biotically. She just wanted a drink without getting a nosebleed, you know? Like an idiot, I stood up. Didn't know what I was gonna do, just something. And Vernus lost it. Beat the crap out of me. Kept shouting how they should have bombed us back to the Stone Age. That's when the knife came up. A military issue talon, right in my face. I cut loose. Full biotic kick right in the teeth. Almost as strong as I can manage now. At 17, that's something.
You wanted to help a girl you cared for. That's a noble thing.
Maybe my intentions were noble, but I lost control. I killed him, Shepard. Snapped his neck. They probably could have saved him if they got him to an infirmary quick enough. But they didn't. Caused a stir when they shipped him home. Bot training was shut down. Kinetics folded a...
Yes, you folded a corporation!
Yeah,
yes!
Maybe I hated that Tyrion. I mean, if one ass was enough to judge a whole race, I'd hate humans too.
A reasonable stance. Keep that level head and we'll do fine.
Staying reasonable is about all we've got left. Everyone else in this galaxy seems to have gone out of their minds. Present company excepted, of course.
I will crush you, Batman. Fold you like paper. I'm gonna do to you what Caden did to Kinetics.
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
I like talking with you, Liara, no matter what the subject.
You have been very understanding with me, Shepard. Very patient. I appreciate that. I know there are some strange beliefs about my people. I am familiar with the legend of Asari promiscuity, but those rumors have little basis in fact. When one of my people joins with an individual from another species, it is a very deep and spiritual exchange. We do not enter lightly into a union.
You make it sound almost mystical.
A true union goes far beyond an ordinary melding. It is a connection that transcends the physical universe. Two become one. Thoughts and senses merge, identities intertwine. Memories and emotions weave themselves together, becoming entangled in a single, rapturous whole.
Like anal.
It is unlike any other experience. In some cases, it can be a truly life-changing event.
It sounds amazing. Are you saying...
No! Oh, no! I am not very good at this, am I? I'm sorry, Shepard. I am trying to explain why I have been so... reserved.
You're anal.
The union is more than just sex. It is the lifeblood of my species, the way we Asari evolve and grow as a society. That is why I have never... that is why we must choose our partners with great care.
I want you to be absolutely sure about this, Liara.
I am only 106, barely an adult by Asari standards, and I spend most of my time absorbed in my research. I never really thought about it. Not until I met you. You are very special to me, Shepard. But with all that's happened, Saren, the Geth, the Reapers, I do not know if we are ready for this.
These are dark times, Liara. Maybe once all this is over.
I'm glad you understand, Shepard. There is too much at stake. We need to put aside our personal feelings and focus on stopping Saren. I wish it did not have to be that way. But we all have to make sacrifices. Let's talk about something else.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Beep 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 boop boop beep 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 boop boop beep beep boop boop booty boop beep beep boop boop boop. All my bags packed. I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye. Actually, it is getting late. I should call it night. So that is what